Hello friends, today we will discuss about the external features of the heart. As you already know, heart is a hollow muscular organ which pumps the blood throughout the body. It is conical in shape, located in the mediastinum, that is middle mediastinum, covered by pericardium, directed downwards, forwards and towards left. Its direction is oblique. And when you come to the measurements of the heart, it roughly measures around 12 cm in length, 9 cm in width and 6 cm in thickness, or anteroposterior length is 6 cm. And when you come to the weight of the heart, so in males it is roughly around 300 grams. And in females, it weighs around 250 grams. Coming to the presenting parts, when you see the heart in anatomical position, it presents an apex. You can see the pointed end here, directed downwards, forwards and towards left. This is the apex formed by left ventricle, and the apex is located in the left fifth intercostal space, 9 cm from mid sternal line. It lies below and medial to the nipple. And when you come to the base, here you can see the left atrium with four pulmonary veins here. You can see opening of four pulmonary veins. And then this is the base, entire thing. It is formed by both right atrium and left atrium. You can see there opening of superior vena cava, opening of inferior vena cava here. So base is formed by atriums. It extends from T5 to T8 in standing, T6 to T9 in recumbent position. So two-third of the base is formed by left atrium, one-third is formed by right atrium. And in base, all the veins open, superior and inferior vena cava into right atrium, four pulmonary veins into the left atrium. And here you can see this is sternocostal surface, as it is related to sternum and ribs. It just lies behind the sternum. And when you observe here, this surface is formed by three chambers, right atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. You can see right ventricle has a significant contribution here, that is right atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. They are supported by the grooves, right atrium and right ventricle, by the anterior atrioventricular groove, also called as right atrioventricular groove, also called as coronary sulcus, as coronary artery runs there, right and left ventricle by the anterior interventricular groove. So these grooves separate these chambers on the sternocostal surface, and these grooves are lodged by the anterior interventricular groove is lodged by right coronary artery and small cardiac veins, anterior interventricular by anterior interventricular artery, or also called as left anterior descending artery and great cardiac vein. So you can remember, anterior interventricular artery is greatly involved in heart attacks. So great cardiac vein is there, you can remember like that. So two-third of the surface, this sternocostal surface, is formed by right ventricle, one-third by left ventricle, partly by right atrium also. And as you come to the diaphragmatic surface, this is the part of the heart which lies directly on the central tendon of the heart. That's why it is the central tendon of diaphragm. That's why it is called as diaphragmatic surface. You can see it is roughly triangular. If you see it in anatomical position here, so you can make out the extent of this diaphragmatic surface. Here it is. It is formed only by ventricle. The base is only formed by atria, diaphragm surface is only formed by ventricles, right and left ventricle, one third by right ventricle, two third by left ventricle. and separated by posterior interventricular groove. So it separates the two ventricles, that's why it is interventricular groove. And this diaphragmatic surface is also separated from the base, that is formed by atria, by a posterior atrioventricular groove or coronary sulcus. And in the posterior interventricular groove, you will see the posterior interventricular artery and middle cardiac vein. Posterior interventricular artery in 90% of the cases is a branch of right coronary artery. And the posterior atrioventricular groove or coronary sulcus, you will see the anastomosis between right coronary artery and the circumflex branch of left coronary artery. And you will also see coronary sinus in the left part of posterior atrioventricular groove. Coronary sinus, the largest venous draining channel of the heart, and it will open into right atrium just beside the opening of inferior vena cava into the interior of right atrium interior. And as you come to the borders now, so the right border extends between the opening of superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, corresponds to sulcus terminalis, inferior border. And you can see it is 2/3 of the inferior border is formed by right ventricle, 1/3 is by left ventricle, and is related to right marginal artery. And as you come here, that is right border, inferior border, this is left border and surface. Left border and surface is partly formed by left atrium and greater contribution by left ventricle. Superior border is formed by atria but obscured anteriorly by the openings of the aorta and pulmonary trunk, or you can say origins of the aorta and pulmonary trunk. So that is right border, you can see inferior border, left border and superior border. So these are the external features of the heart. Thank you.